Well, welcome everyone. My name is Kathleen McClellan. I am the lead product marketing manager for video here at ProQuest, and I wanted to welcome all of you, but most importantly, I really wanted to thank all of you. You guys are on the front lines of education right now, making sure that faculty can get up to speed and do all they need to do in this remote online environment. And I personally, as well as everyone at ProQuest, really do want to thank you for everything you're doing. We thank you for taking the time to be with us today. And I hope what we discuss today will help make that even easier for you and your faculty as we move forward in this really uncertain time. So thank you very much. We did do a similar type of webinar a couple of weeks ago, talking about how we can help faculty adapt to online teaching and learning. It's not specifically video oriented. It does cover some video, but when we follow up with these slides, do click on this link when you get there. It is a great overview of some other resources that you can absolutely use. So what I'm gonna do today is talk with you about the value of video in the classroom, the virtual classroom, as well as the traditional classroom. Talk about some discipline-specific and learning-specific examples, how we can connect the content to your faculty and integrate it into the classroom, as well as answer any questions that you guys have. My world revolves around video. I love it more than anything. I think it's an extremely valuable resource and medium to connect with students. And I'm happy to provide any ideas that will help you guys even be a better resource for your faculty and students as we move forward. So with that, because we are with ProQuest, I will, of course, be using ProQuest content. But the purpose of this is to hopefully give you some ideas and to share ways that video can really be used in the classroom and outside of it. So with that, I think we all know and understand that video really can create greater engagement and learning. And it can do so in many different ways. Again, not only in the online classes, but also in person classes, which we all know are, and we're hoping to get back to as soon as possible. The content itself, whether it be newsreels or documentaries, performances and feature films, it really can support classrooms like never before. So it can provide engagement in the classroom. It can provide tutorials and review prior to and after classes to help support understanding for students. It can be a great way to explain, visualize, and bring in real life examples in the classroom. It also provides access to resources and experts that may not be available in an everyday situation. I don't know about you, but I don't have access to Steve Jobs or Oprah Winfrey, but I can bring in videos and their expertise into classes through video content. It's also a great way to bring in critical thinking through documentaries and get discussions going around really important topics of our time. And it's also a great use for flipped classroom. So being able to review a video prior to class, you can then bring that in and create a discussion lecture environment that's more interactive, less spending the time reviewing content during the classroom. So it really does have a lot of great benefits. And from there, what I wanted to do, my slides will move forward, is focus on a couple ideas in the world of different disciplines. So in the world of history, imagine being able to bring in a newsreel showing the bombing of Pearl Harbor, then going into a documentary talking about eyewitnesses of the same day, then maybe looking at it from a technology perspective and another way of seeing how things have emerged over time, and then going into what we've learned 75 years later. Bringing in video in this kind of effect really changed the way a classroom is created and going on beyond what can be brought into in a textbook. In the world of economics, as I mentioned, bringing in names like Steve Jobs, Tina Brown, Oprah Winfrey, Bill Gates, etc., into the classroom brings that expertise and knowledge that can't be brought in just from a textbook. It also provides insight into big industry issues like gender equality, Black Lives Matter, when Me Too hits home, and other major concepts like just marketing and e-commerce, etc. In the world of the arts, especially now, being able to bring in performances from Broadway HD and the Royal Shakespeare Company, when you can't get to a performance and being able to watch that on your own or in the class, is really amazing. Moving into English and literature, imagine having, having access to performances like Pride and Prejudice, Romeo and Juliet, Great Expectations. Not only reading them, but being able to see them in action brings it all so much more to life for students. In the world of health and medicine, being able to see practical applications and visual explanations of the concepts of study, as well as giving access to really credible sources like the Mayo Clinic and the American Academy of Pediatrics. This content can really enhance any course. Science, technology, the same thing, being able to watch a simulation of acids and bases and how they combine together through a proton. Watching the Earth and Moon cycles. Again, you're limited in a textbook experience and what's happening in the classroom, but this really does allow all kinds of different visualizations and auditory experiences for students. Social sciences is another great example. Imagine going into an intro psych or intro sociology course and being able to see the original obedience experiment or the Stanford prison experiment. Imagine the teachers in the world of education that are no longer being able to get into the classroom, but now they can still watch videos of classroom experiences and continue on their education as opposed to having to stop it because they can't do their student teaching. I'd like to move beyond the disciplines specific stuff and get into different ways that video can be an important part of learning, and that's critical thinking. Again, using documentaries on topics like bioethics or history or healthcare can open up discussions to some of the most pressing issues in our time. In fact, when I go into the live demo showing how to use and integrate it into the classroom, we're going to go into how to survive a plague. Health policy. This is something that's really on everybody's mind right now with the virus, and it's a great way to bring critical thinking into the classroom. It goes beyond that. Think about using video for student success. How do they handle stress management? How they can use exercise to improve their health? How they can transition to the college experience and conquer test anxiety, as well as dealing with finance. Students come today not prepared to go out in the real world and understanding credit. How can they avoid plagiarism? All of these are resources in the world of video that can be used and brought into the educational experience. Going beyond that into tutorials, taking advantage of multidisciplinary tutorial content from like PBS Crash Course or Easy Education in the world of college algebra. Even going into the EMT side of things and being able to watch paramedics on the front line, what a day in the life of a paramedic is, or how-to videos for automotive learning. So this is all really great ways that video can be brought into the educational experience. And then of course there's feature films. So this can be brought in many different ways. I know a lot of professors bring this in for real life applications. So that can be brought in there, but they can also of course be used in film courses and entertainment. I mean, all of the students right now are stuck at home. This is a great resource for them to take advantage of and a great resource for you as a library to be able to provide. So great feature films from content providers like Sony Picture Classics, or even milestone films where a film course can go in and watch directors like Shirley Clark and Charles Burnett, a Nobel Peace Prize winning or Nobel Prize winning playwright like Samuel Beckett's films, Film and Not Film, and even access to two banned World War II dramas from Alfred Hitchcock, like Bon Voyage and Adventure Malgache. So these are, again, just great aspects and videos that can be brought in and really enhance any kind of classroom. So now that you've thought about how to use it in the classroom, how does a library support and promote the video? I think this is really important. We can't just throw it out there at the faculty. We need to be able to get it to them in ways that are most important. So one of the things that we've done at ProQuest is created tweets, already pre-written tweets to help support your social media and making sure that content gets out there. So this is just a quick snapshot of what I have going on for May. I know it is Cinco de Mayo today, but it is also National Astronaut Day. And in our content, or one of our collections called Academic Video Online, what you could do is just cut and paste this tweet, put it on your social media, it links directly out to the film itself, and you can help support some really cool things. So we have tweets already pre-written for you for almost every day of the month. Some fun stuff, some serious stuff, just to make sure that your faculty and your students know that it's available. But it can go beyond that. There are many major things going on in the world right now. Climate change. Imagine doing a showing of the Inconvenient sequel, or even just promoting it to your faculty and students. It's the year of the nurse. Imagine having them being able to watch The American Nurse. It's an amazing documentary about nursing and how it all started. As well as The Unseen Enemy, again, a pandemic, really important to be brought into your patrons now. LGBTQ month is coming up in June. Again, another way to promote and let your students and faculty know all the amazing content that's available out there. As I mentioned with that press kit that we have, these are some other ideas that you can use in your promoting of the content and really connecting it with your faculty. So I saw a great newsletter out there from NYU promoting video content. I mentioned social media. We have resources for you there, already pre-written. We also provide digital banners, press releases for like local newspapers and campus newspapers. Student promotions to let them know that video is really a huge part of the learning process and how they can take advantage of that. And of course, the Everlove LibGuide. Academic Video Online has a major great resource available for you there. Now, the benefit of being a big company like us is that we work with over 800 video providers, and they are working with so many different resources. And one of our providers is called BoClips, and they have wonderful resources to help promote remote learning and how to work with video. So some of these links here are great resources from them. I'm glad that they've created these for us. I'm glad to be able to provide them to you. But ideas like, tips for integrating video into virtual learning, tips for effective remote learning, digital citizenship, which is so important right now with all the transitions. Anyway, these are great resources available, and we can make them available for you guys as well. Now, as we hopefully I've given you some good ideas to spark ideas to share into the classroom. We are, of course, always open and available to provide ideas for any specific course, any specific discipline, whatever. So please do reach out to us. I think that's really important. And to know that we are available to help you guys as well. But as I go into the online demo, I wanted to bring up a new film that we have. It's called How to Survive a Plague. It features Dr. Anthony Fauci, of course, a big name right now. It's from one of our new providers called Film Platform, who brought in over 500 new documentaries to our collection. It's just really great, again, for that critical thinking point. But I wanted to use this as a great example to show how we can make clips how we can bring a video into your LMS, your learning management systems like Blackboard and Canvas, as well as the social media that I was talking about. So I'm just popping right over to our platform. I'm sure, as I mentioned, Anthony Fauci, this video itself talks about the AIDS pandemic and his involvement there. And hopefully from a critical thinking perspective, I think this would be an amazing film to be brought in and have students watch and then have them see what the comparisons, the differences, the parodies of what was going on with the AIDS epidemic and how he's helping his knowledge and what he's learned and in his experience here today with the coronavirus. I just think it could be a really amazing film that's brought in. So this is, of course, Dr. Anthony Fauci back in the 80s. His hair looks a little different, although he is still very recognizable. And again, I'm in my platform. And what you can see here, I'm going to go ahead and play the video so you can see it. One thing that we do have on our platform, which I think is very important, is the captions on screen, as well as a scrolling and searchable transcript. So from here, I've typed in Fauci. I can then go through any of the instances of Fauci. Maybe I'm doing some sort of a clip around Dr. Fauci. I can then clip right into this point into the film and go directly in there to make a clip. So clip making, the purpose of it is to get the content that you want right into your classes as needed. So, you know, as we know, we don't all have the luxury of watching a 2-hour film, especially if you have a 50-minute lecture, but what you can do is create a clip. So with just a click of a mouse into the clip making feature, it's very easy to do just that. I can create a new clip. I can customize the clip however I would like. I can make it any kind of description here. So maybe I want to do some kind of critical thinking, a comparison and contrast. Maybe I just want the students to watch for a Tuesday's class. So I can do all of that here. And clip is as easy as dragging and dropping this nice little slider right here. Now we've made it even easier for you to click on the transcript and you've got your timestamps right here. So I can easily move the slider where I want it specifically and create the clip from there without having to, you know, write anything down and do all that kind of stuff. You'll also see how long the clip is up in this left-hand corner, so you know how much time it's gonna take up in your class. And then most importantly, you need to decide how you're going to want to share it. So do I want to keep it within my own account? Do I want to make it public, everyone on the platform, or keep it just within my institution? It's up to you how you want to share the content. So the clips are then stored on the side of the film itself, so you'll always know where they are. And you can see here, I've named this one Dr. Fauci. This is my description that I wrote in here. And these carrots right here allow me to go in and either edit, delete, or share. So I can always change it up if I want to make it shorter or longer. But I think what's most important, especially as we're helping faculty, is how to share it. And we can do so in a few different ways. So from right here, I'm able to just grab a permalink and integrate it in as I would like. I can also embed into my course as needed. So you can do that through this embed code. The other thing that we provide on our platform is what is called LTI capabilities. So for those of you who are not familiar with that, that allows faculty to embed video, whether it be a clip or a full video, into their learning management system like Blackboard or Canvas, and it allows students watch it in a single sign-on experience. So they don't have to go in and re-authenticate into our platform. They can watch it directly through the learning management system and take advantage of it within that program. So the best way to do that is to connect with connect us with your learning management person, and we share and get everything all set up. They share the embed codes and the secrets and keys that's set up on the platform for you guys, so faculty can go in and do an easy integration into their courses. Of course, too, we do have citing available as well. And then, of course, the social media that I mentioned. So you can use my PR kit, something like that, write your own tweets, or you can share directly from the platform itself, have it go directly into your Facebook or Twitter account, and write up your tweets as you'd like there. So I'm going to go back over to the slides right here. Let me make it all nice and big for you guys. And go on to just a quick overview of what we talked about today. So again, there's so much value for video in the classroom. We've seen it on our end with our usage going through the roof, with people using our products. I'm sure you've gotten a lot of requests for streaming video. This does make sure that you are all set up for the remote learning, however long that may last. It does promote engagement, promote in tutorials, great explanations, critical thinking. It supports that flipped classroom and so much more. What I do think that video does is it does maximize the use of your library collections in the classroom. It's great for teaching and learning. It connects the libraries with students and instructors. It increases student engagement and really fosters that meaningful learning. It's a great way to measure and demonstrate the library value. And then most importantly, as we're supporting faculty and students, it reduces your risk of copyright infringement. So all of this content that I've shown you today is licensed for educational use and really great to be brought into the classroom. So jokingly, I put a nice little X on the handshake up there under the current circumstances. I really do want to thank you all for being here today. But I know we can't shake hands, so I'm giving virtual handshakes and high fives and all that kind of good stuff. I'd like to open the floor for any kind of questions. If you guys have any, I'm happy to answer them and provide any further insights. Otherwise, I thank you for being here.
Thanks, Kathleen. I did see someone asking about where are the PR tweets located that you had referenced in?
Oh, yes. So the PR, when you guys get this slide as a follow-up or these slides as a follow-up, I have it linked in here under the Avon PR kit. So if you are using Academic Video Online, this is all set up and ready for you and ready to go. Great question. Thank you.
Looks like someone maybe having a problem with that link, but we'll follow up with them directly after the call to see if we can lock down if that's an issue with okay. that. And then we had a couple questions come through directly on chat where it said, where can I find the videos you're referencing in today's presentation?
Yeah, that's great. So all of that is in Academic Video Online. It is a ProQuest product. It's a multidisciplinary video collection that's all over almost 70,000 videos for the academic experience. And I think we're going to share a link at the end in the chat. If you're interested in learning more about that, we can help with that.
All right. And are all the videos licensed for academic use?
Yes, absolutely. In Academic Video Online, yep.
Yep. And then last question, it says, as a provider, are you able to help us with ideas for selections of content for our courses?
Yeah, actually, we love doing that. I had so much fun putting this presentation together because I think it just shows the richness of the content that we have. So absolutely, reach out to me. I'll pop my email address down here at the end. If you are interested in ideas for a certain discipline, a certain course, let me know. Myself, as well as my product manager, love this content. We'll be happy to give you ideas.
And another question that asked, is the clip making feature available in all Alexander Street / ProQuest video platforms?
For all the video products, absolutely.
And that's the last question. Oh, wait, I got one more. They're asking if the clip making is available as only an option in Academic Video Online or other products as well. So
all of the video, yep, any video product from Alexander Street or ProQuest has the clip making feature. Yeah, I love that. Yeah, it's super important as we integrate into the classroom. It allows really focused content and it helps us save time, and it also can allow, access in the classroom for a short period and then an idea to move forward into the full film as, a follow-up or precursor to the class. Great for the flipped classroom.
Looks like that's the last question that comes through the QA.
Perfect. Well, we did that in under 30 minutes. I really do thank you guys for being here with us. Let us know if you have any other questions. Please reach out to me. I'm always happy to help. And thank you for joining us, and thank you for all you're doing to keep education moving forward. We really do appreciate it, and I know your faculty do as well. Have a wonderful day.